If you play League of Legends, you might have heard of Kai'Sa. Kai'Sa?
KSI?
Kai'Sa's the latest and greatest marksman in the game. She's a high-risk, high-burst, high-mobility assassin type of deal. And if you start playing her, one of the first things you're gonna think to yourself is, well, this champion's fucking confusing. Either that or you're smarter than me. And considering my target audience, I do solemnly doubt that. Pause for laughter for all the intellectuals. But I digress. If you've seen her, you might have thought to yourself, should I play Kai'Sa? And today, I'm gonna help you find out. Kai'Sa is Kassadin's daughter. When she was in the void with her father, she got all emotions sucked out of her. That must have sucked. Alright, let's rewind. Kai'Sa is Kassadin's daughter. When she was in the void with her father, she got all emotions sucked out of her. Which is why her voice lines are so bland and boring. Wait, saying that is bland and boring. I better kill myself. Alright, last rewind, I promise. Kai'Sa is Kassadin's daughter. When she was in the void with her father, she got all emotions sucked out of her. I wonder what she sucked out of him.
Winner joke.
Oh, that's funny. Oh, that's fucking funny. That was a good one.
Incest gets me every time.
But back on fucking track. Riot overcomplicates all her abilities to you and she seems really confusing at first. But let me sum up the saga of information they present you with. Let me start off by saying I'm delighted to see Riot finally giving us another hybrid scaling champ. It's been 2 years since we had Jhin, who barely had any AP on his Q, which leaves us with an extremely inconsistent trap. And although I won't get into the exact numbers, every single one of Kai'Sa's scalable abilities, including her passive, scale with both AD and AP. Can we get a round of applause for Riot Games? Good fucking job. In fact, a round of applause won't cut it. As an award, I give Riot 3 ice cream cones, a ticket to the EULCS, and a cigarette.
Congratulations. It's well deserved. Oh, my God.
Almost her entire kit revolves around plasma, which is essentially purple smegma. You apply these stacks to your enemies with your auto attacks, W, or if your teammates use immobilizing effects on them. The more smegma stacks are on them, the more damage your auto attacks deal. If you attack someone with 4 smegma stacks on them, they basically go... The second part of her passive is Evolved Weapon. She can evolve her basic abilities based on what bonus stats she has, but I'll go over each ability separately. Her Q, Icathian Rain, which sounds more like a slang for a golden shower than anything else, releases 6 missiles that disperse evenly among nearby enemies. Note that champions take significantly reduced damage after the first missile. If she has over 100 bonus attack damage from either items or leveling, she instead fires 12 missiles. What I'm really trying to say is that
every time I'm in the streets, I make the gun go.
Her W, Void Seeker, is an incredibly long-range skill shot which gives vision similar to Ashe's Hawk Shot. If you hit an enemy, it grants true sight over them and applies 2 smegma stacks. Unless you have over 100 bonus AP, in which case it applies 3 smegma stacks and refunds half the cooldown. Her E, Supercharger, aka Yeet on these goofy niggas, charges up for a short period of time while she sprints like she's about to burst out the blicky on the block and gun these hoes down. The more bonus attack speed she has, the more movement speed she gets. If she has over 100% bonus attack speed, her E also makes her invisible, which is perfectly balanced. And finally her ult, Killer Instinct. She dashes to an enemy with smegma, and shields herself for 3 seconds. The incredible part of the ult is the fucking range. At max rank, it has a range of 2500. This ability is what makes Kai'Sa a disgusting champion. If you get sniped with her W, she literally teleports behind you and...
NANI?!
Heil Hitler.
We had the Lee Syndrome, now we have the Kai'Sa condition for players who can't help but smash that R button every time they see an enemy with smegma. Altogether, Kai'Sa's abilities culminate in what the Lee community refers to as pure cancer. One of those champions that are fucking fantastic when you play them. Let me give you an example. I love Zoe, but only when I play her. Her nerf is well fucking deserved. And I think much like Vayne and Yasuo, Kai'Sa will have a dedicated player base of children with ADHD, juiced up on prescribed amphetamines. I truly believe that champions like this appeal to people who suffer from lasting mental illness. Speaking of mental illness, I got placed in Gold 3 this season. And I'll be streaming my valiant attempts to remedy the situation now that I have my apartment back. When you're done watching the video and
hitting like,
all you have to do is click the link in the description to be taken to the
highest quality stream on Twitch TV.
And now that I'm done plugging myself, it's time to weigh the pros and cons of playing Kai'Sa. Pros: She's not nearly as boring as most marksmen in the league. She has impressive damage, incredible burst, and insurmountable mobility. She definitely squats, and you can smear smegma on your enemies. Oh, and if you happen to be autistic enough to not feel safe on the rift, you can even put on a helmet. Isn't that neat? Cons. Short auto attack range. She's squishier than my asshole. Yeah. I guess that's all I can think of, really. Conclusion. Yeah, she's pretty fucking good, you know? Hey, you guys want to see an accurate representation of what playing Tyze is like? And on that note, I think it's time to round out this review by rating Tyze based on her looks, gameplay, and my personal enjoyment.
Looks!
Now, I could just say she's Kerrigan from StarCraft, and that'd be a valid point. But I could also take it a step further and mention that all they did was take birthing hips, nice tits, and a pretty face, and then rum-corrupted it with Kha'Zix and these jet engines from Spore. Her splash art looks alright, but doesn't really do anything to stand out. I mean, this could be the Chinese splash art for Morgana for all I know. Her in-game model looks pretty sleek, as you'd expect from a champion being released in 2018. I give her looks 12.5. Her gameplay speaks for itself, which is why the rating I'm gonna give her gameplay is her gameplay.
That's what I'm talking about.
And finally, for the only score that actually matters, my personal enjoyment. Now, since this was played on the PBE, I've naturally compensated for how much I think I'd enjoy her on the live servers, and she gets a solid 3 lava lamps out of 5 lava lamps. But I'm not done there. She also gets a fresh shampoo advertisement.
Introducing all new Palmolive Naturals shampoos and conditioners. New packaging.
Damn, that's fucking good. And finally, to answer the question, should you play Kaisa? Well, in the words of the 14-year-old Swedish kid I played with on the PBE to make this video,
should you play Kaisa? No, play Teemo Jungle instead.